there are many, many religions, but there are certain religions that even came out opposing the Vedas, like Buddhism, Jainism, Sikhism, and yet, of course, because they are in India, we call them as part of Hinduism, and sometimes there is a call for them to be called as Hindus, and they don't like that.
Of course not.
But they coexist with everybody else, intermarry, they live alongside each other, but they seem reluctant to sort of melt into one cultural pot or one religious pot, so to speak.
This is good in a way, because this means that we are a spiritual democracy. So even though a majority of who we call Hindus subscribe to the idea of Vedas as the scripture of authority, majority of Hindus will subscribe to the idea of Vedas as a scripture of authority, we discover certain groups within India, from the time of Jainism and Buddhism, they said we rather move away from it because some of the material in it doesn't agree with us, doesn't agree with our digestion. So we would rather, like Buddha said, no, I'm not interested. So the Buddhist scripture came from the lips of Buddha. So in a way, this is, if you like, more reformed aspects of what Dharma is all about. But the word is, Dharma was used by all the four Indian traditions, saying Dharma means making sense of the human condition, was central feature. Like Buddhism doesn't look about a God. Jainism doesn't have a creator God. So two of the four traditions do not even mention the word God. And yet they are trying to resolve the human condition without reference to a God. Do we say, oh, horrible people? We say, no, this is your way. And Hinduism also comes in many, many different flavors. Like, for example, non-theistic Hinduism, not focusing on a God, but focusing on our true nature. So this variation is something that we have encouraged. We have not snuffed it out. That is why Buddhism, Jainism, Sikhism flourish in India, because this is the variation that we see, and we observe it, and we allow for it, and we don't vilify it, we don't hurt it. We agree with it, saying this is the way you are trying to address the same issue that we are addressing. We have got this fixation on Vedas. That is our fixation, if you like. You don't have that. Good luck to you. So we are not, I'm not fixated on the Vedas either. You'll be surprised. Even though many Hindus create, Mr. Lakhani, how dare you say Vedas give you? I say, you try and read it, my friend. It is not easy to subscribe to. A lot of stuff in it will make you shudder. I'm telling you bluntly. So even the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, there are certain verses that will make me say, is this true Hinduism? This is horrendous stuff. So this idea of being fixated on scripture is something that the Hindus kind of hang on with their dear life. But this other three traditions that came out of India said, no, we rather move away. We agree with the central features like law of karma, reincarnation, but this fixation on the scripture of Vedas is something that we want to move away from. Our own prophets are given, if you like, a more interesting vision of what is the meaning of what dharma. So we coexist very nicely.